Hello everyone, I'm Irene Colasanti and I'm a student of Sapienza, University of Rome. Today I will talk about my bachelor thesis that was focused on natural-based products for cleaning copper and copper alloys artifacts. In particular, we know that copper and bronze are among the first and the most widespread metallic materials used in human history, and we know also that this typology of material are subjected to corrosion phenomena. In particular, corrosion patinas can be divided into noble patinas and non-noble patinas. Noble patinas are patinas that can protect an object from further corrosion phenomena and at the same time can enhance the aesthetic aspect of an object, while non-noble patinas are patinas that can weigh on the aesthetic aspects or on the integrity of the artifact. For this, when we talk about the conservation of copper and bronze artifacts, we have to talk about the cleaning treatment that is the removal of non-noble patinas. While noble patinas generally must be preserved. In this work, I focus on chemical cleaning that involve the use of some chelating agents. The most common chelator used for cleaning copper and bronze is EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. This is a chelator poorly biodegradable and is particularly resistant to water purification, so has a negative impact on the environment. For this reason, I studied the application of some green chelators to find an eco-friendly alternative to EDTA that can be available in the field of cultural heritage. I start from a bibliography research to understand the composition of ancient bronzes, in particular to understand the typology of corrosion products that are in general found on these bronzes. And I found that in general the most common corrosion products are cuprite and aurite, that are noble patinas, and brochantite, that is sulfates, and these are non-noble patinas, non-noble patina. Particular also artificial corrosion methods to replicate this typology of patinas was studied. And was found that in general acid and basic solutions are used. At the end, the bibliography research was focused on the common green chelator used in green conservation and also in industry. And for this, we decide to test four amino acids and two green chelators, two green industrial chelators. All of them were compared with EDTA taken as the reference. Subsequently, an experimental part were carried out. In particular, this part was divided into three phases. The first one is the analysis of extraction capacity of chelators, and then cleaning tests were carried out on artificial corroded patina plates and on cleaning test of real artifacts. In particular, we have to say that before cleaning test, patinas of plates and the real artifacts were characterized with Raman and FTIR spectroscopy. For the extraction capacity of clathrate, was analyzed with ECPOES, and we use three powder copper compounds that are cuprite, tenorite, and brochanzite, keep in contact with seven chelators. For every test, we decide for extraction times, and then after filtration and dilution, we study this with the instrument. The results are that the two best green chelators to be used on the subsequent phases of the study were selected in terms of the preservation of noble patinas. In particular, in this case, we can say that alanine and GLDA are the two chelators that preserve cuprite and tenorite, while at the same time, always alanine and GLDA remove non-noble patinas, in this case brochanzite. For this, we decide to use alanine and GLDA for cleaning test of plates and real artifacts. Cleaning tests on artificial corroded plates were carried out with cellulose pulp, keeping contact the chelating solution with plates for different times. Cleaning tests were analyzed then with UVV spectroscopy and also with the spectrocolorimetry. In this case, spectra were collected before the artificial corrosion process, after the corrosion process, and then after the cleaning test. Results of both UVV spectroscopy and spectrocolorimetry gave similar results. In particular, we note that in the first typology of plates characterized by a tenorite patina, alanine is the chelator that preserve the patina, while GLDA is the chelator that better remove tenorite, while EDTA is the one that is an intermediate between alanine and GLDA. At the same time, the second and the third typology of plates, artificial corroded plates, characterized by sulfate patinas. In this case, alanine is the chelator that better remove this typology of non-noble patina. At the end, the conservator Laura Rivalori clean some artifacts, in particular some coins and a copper painting. We note that in the coin M1, GLDA and EDTA remove noble patinas, while alanine preserve it. And for this reason, the coin M2 and M3 were clean only with alanine. At the same time, the painting. Were clean with all the three chelators, and in particular we note the same that we note on the plates, that in other words it's that GLDA remove efficacy noble patinas, while alanine is more respectful of noble patinas, and for this in the areas of the cleaning with alanine, we note a less shining surface. In conclusion, we can say that GLDA is not suitable for the conservation of cultural heritage, in particular for the cleaning of copper and copper alloy artifacts. EDTA is the capacity to extract not only noble platina, but especially, but also noble platina and especially cuprite. While alanine has efficacy effectiveness with noble platina, but at the same time respect cuprite and cenobite. Furthermore, thanks to its natural origin, it is also environmentally friendly. For this, in conclusion, we can say that alanine is a valid alternative to EDTA, and we hope that even with future study, its use in the field of conservation of cultural heritage will expand. Thank you for your attention.